Hi, this is Kurt with Travers Tool Company. Today, we're going to talk about the OTMT drill bit sharpener. They come in two sizes. We're just going to talk about the smaller one today, but they both work exactly the same way. Well, to be right up front with you, when I was first asked to do a video on this grinder, I was thinking, well, I've spent 35 years, actually more than 35 years, just grinding them by hand. So then I get this thing and I start playing around with it, kind of skeptically, and I actually fell in like with it. So I think I need to add one to my shop. Let's take a look at what we have here. We have the two pieces that hold the collet. Speaking of collets, here's all our collets in nice order. Each one is labeled for the size range in there. If you're wondering what these are Allen keys that you'll need to, there it is, that you'll need to make a few adjustments. This one goes over here. And this one is used to take the cover off. So we have all that. And everything else is the machine itself. So let's learn how to use this thing. So let's take a look at the different components on this drill sharpening machine. So the first place we're going to go is to set the web diameter of the drill. Now, in case you're wondering, the web diameter is the thickness in the center of the drill, the smallest part in that center. So we'll set that. We have a dial here to tell you where to set it. Then we're going to come over here. That's what this is for. And this goes in there to do the first step of the sharpening process. And these other two holes in the top, you can see the labels up here. This is to grind the relief angle. And this step is to grind the split point, which is always nice. That's optional. If you don't want the split point, just skip that step. Well, let's get started here. Let's select a collet. I have a 3/8 drill bit. So looking at the labels here, and here's something from 0.36 to 0.39. 3/8 is 0.375. So we'll pick that collet. Now this collet only fits in the nose piece. If you're familiar with an ER collet, normally this is the side that the tool goes on. With this machine, it goes the other way. So that goes into the collet holder. Just give the other piece a couple of screws. Don't tighten it up, you don't need to yet. And then slide the drill in there. And now is where we use the web diameter setter. So there's a point right on the label right here. I'm gonna put that right around 0.375, because again, this is a 3/8 drill bit. Now with everything loose, I'm gonna stick this in here. Before I put it in, you should see there's a little step down here, and there's a flat on this, actually two flats. So I need to line up the flat to that step so that it stops it from turning. Next, I'm gonna push the drill bit all the way in, as far as it'll go, until it stops on the machine. The most important thing that you're gonna find about sharpening a drill bit is this first step. If you don't get the point, if you don't get that cutting edge of the point of the drill bit right up against that stop, the drill's gonna be in the wrong position. So you have to push it all the way forward and twist it until the cutting edge comes up against the stop over here. And hold it there while you're tightening. Lock it in there pretty good. Give it a crack loose and pull it out. And that's where it's supposed to be. Here's another little tip I found out about. If you remove your drill and your collet holder from the machine and you realize it's still a little bit loose and you need to tighten it up, don't tighten it with your hands. It moves the drill and it's going to be in the right, I'm sorry, it's going to be in the wrong place. So loosen it up again, put it back in there, and start all over again. And tighten only while it's in the machine, not once you take it out.
Just a little tip here.
this dial to set the diameter of the drill, or the drill point actually. It's really just a thumb screw, and you can actually turn it all the way out. And as you do, this block comes up. If it's turned out too far, that drill point that goes in here is going to be in the wrong place. To get it in the right place, screw it all the way in. Doesn't have to be super tight, just snug. Once it's all the way down, now back it up to the drill point angle. I'm sorry, not the drill point angle, the diameter of the drill that you're going to grind. All right, next thing we're going to do is, before we stick the drill bit in there, we're going to notice that on the bottom, there's a few numbers and lines. Well, that's the angle of the drill point. Whatever angle you want your drill bit ground at, you need to line up that number and that line with this red arrow on the front. And the way you do that, you see that little socket head cap screw down there? You take the hex key that comes with it and just loosen up that screw, and you can just slide this back and forth to whatever angle you want to grind. So I'm going to put it back on 135 because that's what I want to do for this particular drill bit. Make sure it's tight. And now you see this part moves a little bit, but it comes to a stop. So that's going to be important in just a minute. You also see these flats on here, and those flats line up with the drill holder or the collet holder. So you might want to hold that and just go right in there with the holder until the flats engage. Then turn the machine on. Keep going back and forth while you're pushing it in a little bit. Just a little bit of pressure is fine. Then I don't hear any grinding anymore, so I'll take it out, turn it over. Don't forget the second side, that's important. There we go. That's all there is to that. Now we're going to grind the relief angle on the back of the cutting edge of the drill. And do you see these two pins right here? Those pins have to line up with this flat, and then that one. You have to do both sides. So I cheated a little bit. I put a white mark over here because I'm standing in front of the machine, not in the back of it. So when the flat lines up with my white mark, I know that the pins are all set in the flat on the back. All right, let's turn it on. Insert the drill. This one doesn't move much, but you still have to roll it back and forth until the grinding stops, even though it's just a little bit. Around here. Do exactly the same thing again. Okay, and that's that step. So now we're going to put our drill bit in the point slitting station. And to do that, you see that little pin right there? That's going to line up with the flats, either one, on the collet holder that's holding the drill. So let's turn it on and insert the drill. You hear that grinding? Keep on turning. Turn the collet holder all the way in each direction until it stops. Once you hear that the grinding stops, then turn it around.
Do it again.
And we are finished. One little tip about taking that drill bit out of there. When that collet, just like a lot of ER collets, they kind of hold the tool even after you release it. So if you just tap it on a workbench, that releases the collet inside and the drill falls out very easily. Just remember to grab onto it so it doesn't fall onto the floor and you need to sharpen it all over again. So look at the point on that thing. We've got the split point right in here. Lots of relief on the back. Nice clean cutting edge. I don't know, I like this machine. So here's some good news and some bad news. Well, starting with the bad news, the wheel does eventually wear out, but it's a grinding wheel. They all do. The good news is we have replacements for them. And some more good news is that it only takes one wheel in here to do all the operations. So once it does wear out, that's all you need to replace, is just the one. There's a few reminders that are just worth taking note of. One is that you have to set the tip first, and it's got to be right, or the drill bit is just not going to drill once you go through the sharpening process. Another thing to remember is that when you put the holder in each one of the holes, you have to remember to turn it. On this one, it doesn't turn very much, but you still have to turn it a little bit until it stops. Otherwise, you won't get the right angles on your drill bit. Remember, it's a two-flute drill bit. There are two flats on the holder. I know me, and I know I would get into this and just do one side and realize I missed the other side entirely. So remember, do each side twice and use each flat to get both flutes of the drill bit. Well, I hope you have a better understanding on how these things work. And even if maybe you're like me and did it all by hand previously, maybe consider one of these things. I know I kind of like it myself. If you have any questions about them, send an email to us in tech support and we'll get your questions answered.